Hello, in this video I will show you static routing of connecting two network using two different routers. So first take one PC here, another PC here. Say these two PC representing two different network, and we are having two different router in between them. One is here, another is here. Now we want to communicate from this PC to this PC and vice versa. So first connect them TI0 and TI0, and this side I'm doing gigabit ethernet 0x1 port, okay, both the cases, and here 0x0 port to this PC fast ethernet 0. Now we have three network actually here. One is one is this one is one network, okay, and this one is another network, and this is another network, okay. So we have three network, and we need to have three different IP scheme for these three different networks. So what IP scheme I'm going to use, I'm just writing here for this network 192.168.1.1 IP address of this PC with subnet mask 255.255.255.0, okay, and to this port where this PC is connected to the router, that will have IP address 192.168.1.2 with the same subnet mask, okay, and here this PC will have IP address say 192.168.3.1, okay, and this router where this PC is connected, that will have 3.2. Okay, so in the same way this port will have 192.168.2.1 with same subnet mask. I'm not changing subnet mask for everything, okay. And this one is going to give in 192.168.2.2, okay, where this router is connected to this router, okay. So this is the situation. Now you have to configure the network. So first you go to this PC, go to desktop, IP address 192.168.1.1, subnet mask is 255.255.255.0, done. Go to this PC, desktop, IP configuration 192.168.3.1, and subnet mask is this one, okay, done. Now still you can see that this connection is showing red, that is it is not communicating with the router. So we have to configure the routers. It is 0x0 port, so 0x0 port, go to CLI, say no. Next is enable. Next configure terminal. Okay, next is go to you can give the host name. host name, say this is router 1, and now go to the interface, which interface we want to configure. Gigabyte Ethernet 0x0. Okay, what do you want to configure? IP address, you give IP address 192.168.1.2 with the same subnet mask 255.255.255.0. So it is configure. Now say no short. Now you can say this line is activated. Okay, but if we want to ping from this PC to this router, you can say it is successful. Okay, now the same thing we have to do with this router. Go to CLI command prompt, say no, next enable, next is the configure terminal, give a host name, say R2 or router 2, and we want to configure interface gigabyte 0x0 with IP address 192.168.3.2 with subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Okay, do no short and exit. Okay, now you can see that this line is also up. Now when we want to communicate from this router to this router, that we have to declare the default gateway on this router. So what will be the default gateway? Address, IP address of the port where this PC is connected, or this network is connected. This network is connected to this router through this IP address. So that will be the default gateway. Okay, so default gateway for this is 2. Okay, so this is the default gateway. And here also I have to set the default gateway. Sorry. Okay, now you can see that this connection is still down, it is not allowing to communicate. So again we have to configure the other, this interface and this interface, to which port this wire is connected. So let's do it. We want to go to int gigabyte first. I need to exit from here. Next I have to int gigabyte ethernet 0x1, IP address is 192.168.2.1 as I had written here. Okay, with the subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Okay, no short. Okay, exit. Okay, so this interface of this router is configured. Now for this router, this interface we need to configure. So interface gigabyte 0x1, we need to give IP address 2.2 with this subnet mask. Okay, so it is assigned. Go do no short. Okay, so you can see that it is, you know, exit. Now you can see it is allowing to communicate. Now is this enough? If I send a packet from this to this router, okay, successful. Or if we ping from this to this router, this PC to this router, it was successful. But if I want to ping from this PC to this router, it is failed. Okay, so thing is that this router is not allowing this network to access this network or this network, right? If I want to access from here, ping from here to here, you can say it is failed to ping. So what we need to do, we need to do an IP route. So what is IP route? When from this network some request for this network will come, we have to route that request. We have to tell that this router one that route this request through this port, through this port. Okay, so give that information to this router. Okay, so what is that information? I have to give IP route address of this side network. Okay, what is the IP scheme for that network? 192.168.3.0. okay, with subnet mask 255.255.0, through which port? Through this port we want to send the requests. So 192.168.2.1. okay, so not sorry 2.2. okay, so that it will find this port here. Yeah, so do it. Okay, it is done. Now exit. Okay, now try to communicate from here to here. It is failed. So you can configure this side also. So IP route 192.168.1.0 with 255.255.255.0 through which port? Through this, right? So through this port. So 192.168.2.1. Done. Exit. Okay, so this is called what? Static IP routing. So let's try. Okay, it is successful. Again, ping from here to here. Yeah, it is successful, right? Or you can ping it manually. Go to the command prompt. Ping to the other network, which is 192.168.3.1. You can see it is, you know, getting reply from the other network. So thank you for watching. Kindly subscribe my channel.